Hey Mountain Kids, this is Rob Wade with a little more Outdoor Core for you, grade level 6. All right, you guys. So I know as you're going out to your creek spot, my hope for you, my goal is that you become the expert of your creek spot. Nobody in the world will know more about your creek spot than you, because you'll go there all throughout the year and study it high to low, up to down, bank to bank, and really get to know what's there. And really all you need is your curiosity. You've got your senses to use your ability to see and to feel, to touch, to hear the sounds. All of that will be part of this. But don't worry about having official science words and names for everything you see. If you can describe it as the best you can, then you're doing the work of science. So I'm at Silver Creek in Meadow Valley, which is pretty close to where I live. I happen to be over here, so I thought I'd take a walk, and I was reminded about why I love this creek. So it's kind of a weird thing when you're looking here at this creek. It kind of looks like there's like a channel through mud or whatever down here. There's a bunch of different loose rocks here in the middle, but the sides are kind of trippy, they're kind of different. So this is what I want you to get about this, what we're looking at here, and this is what I'm going to want you to do at your own creek spot. So almost all of the rock that we're going to be seeing along the river are going to be big, small, way different sizes, boulders all the way down to little pieces of sand, bits of rock that are slowly being pushed down and carried by the river. But a lot of times the banks of the river, while I look up here, this is all soil with lots of rocks in it, some of them smaller or bigger, and then you come down here a little bit lower and you just think it's more of the same. But actually what I have down here is a thing called bedrock. So bedrock is solid rock, and sometimes a river, as it is carving through the land, it hits bedrock. And this is not just a big old boulder, this is solid rock that just keeps going and going. So if you look at this right here, what we're looking at is not a muddy bank with a bunch of gravel and rocks stuck in it. This is actually a kind of sedimentary rock known as conglomerate, which basically is a solid rock type that's made up of tons and tons and tons of rock that all got welded and stuck and hardened together. And so that's what you're looking at here. That's not a muddy bank with lots of rock. This is a solid piece of bedrock. I'm gonna get down into it so you can see it a little bit better. So all this in here, I can't pull these rocks out. It's solid. This isn't mud. This is like hard, hard rock. And it's all just one piece. It's almost like if you took a bunch of gravel and you poured cement in it, you'd turn it into a thing that would be quite a bit like conglomerate rock. But all of these rocks here, they're stuck into this whole thing because the entire thing is bedrock. Even up here on where it looks like it's just muddy ground, and there is some mud and stuff in here, but this is all solid rock. I can't pull any of these little pieces of pebble or gravel out. So when you go to your creek spot, I'm not thinking that you're necessarily gonna see conglomerate. It's not a totally unique sedimentary rock, but it is kind of unique. And you don't always find it along a river like I am right here. It's kind of a real cool feature that the water is slowly cutting through. And it takes a lot more work for a river to cut through solid bedrock than it does just through soil and land like this up here on the high banks. So your marching orders, your goal, and what I'm sending you to do out to do at your creek spot is I want you to see if there's any bedrock at your spot. And it could look lots of different ways, but I want you to, as you get to know your creek spot, get to know what's there. Is it all just soil and, you know, what they call alluvial material? Is it all just dirt and earth that the river or your creek has cut its way through? And now there's different sized rocks, as we can see down here in the creek itself? Or does it actually cut right through bedrock? So again, this is you're going out and looking for bedrock at your creek spot, or maybe just above it or just below it. So you can learn a little bit more about the way that water and land play together in the watershed. All right, have fun, mountain kids. Get on out there and learn a little more. Take care. Bye.